if you're ready to jump into the role of a sales rep for a pharmaceutical or medical device company in 2021, then you want to watch this video to learn about three vital things you must have to succeed. But before we get started, please hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you'll be notified whenever I've got a new piece of content for you. All my content is designed to help you succeed as a medical sales representative. And when you hit that like button and you subscribe, it really helps out the channel. So thank you very much. Now, the pharmaceutical and medical device equipment industries attract some of the top salespeople in the world. What is it that makes the industry so appealing? Well, obviously, some people are attracted by the earning potential, which is significant, and which I'm going to discuss in a future video, so watch for that. Others are drawn to the thrill of succeeding in a very competitive environment, and some enjoy the flexibility that being a medical sales rep offers them. Now, the majority of people are driven by a sincere desire to make a difference in the lives of people, both their customers and the patients who their customers serve. Now, if you've decided to give this career a shot, then there are three vital things that you must have to succeed. Number one is confidence. Nothing will kill your career in medical sales faster than a lack of confidence. When you go into a meeting with a healthcare professional, you have got to be able to speak to that professional on his or her level. If you sound or you look the slightest bit unsure about your product, service, or your goals, you're not going to succeed. Now, introducing yourself with a strong voice and tone, a warm smile, a firm handshake, of course, except during COVID-19, and maintaining eye contact with your HCP or your healthcare professional all demonstrate your confidence in yourself and your role. Also, demonstrating that you're happy to be there because you have something of immense value for that healthcare professional and his or her patients is going to go a long way towards driving your success in this role. Now, obviously, for you to be confident, you have to have a wealth of knowledge about your product and the industry that your product is in. Again, that's something that I'm going to discuss in a future video to help you to understand what you can do to increase your product knowledge and the knowledge of your market and the knowledge of your customer's business. So that's the first thing. You've got to have a very high level of confidence. Now, secondly, you need conviction. Now, conviction doesn't just involve being completely sure or convinced that you have the best product or service, and that the lives of your customers and their patients will absolutely improve by using your product or service. Of course, that's important, but conviction also involves how true you are to your values, both in your career and in your personal life. Living with conviction means that you're true to those values in every aspect of life. If you're at all active on social media, as an example, be aware that what you post leaves clues, either good or bad, as to how true you're being to your values. So for example, if you claim to be a compassionate person, but you post insensitive comments on places like Twitter or Facebook, your potential employer and your customers may conclude that you're inconsistent in what you claim to value and what you actually do when you think no one is watching. In the medical sales industry, hiring managers want to find individuals who live and work true to their convictions. So that's the second key element or key thing that you must have if you're going to succeed in the medical sales industry. Third, and the last one for this video, is compassion. In one study that was done, almost 100% of HR managers and employees who were surveyed said that they think it's important to have emotional intelligence. Now, emotional intelligence involves four vital characteristics. Those are self-awareness, self-management, social awareness, and relationship management. If you're wondering how well you're doing when it comes to the level of EI that you possess or emotional intelligence that you possess, you can take an online assessment to get a clear picture of your abilities in this area, as well as what you can do to make improvement. Another thing is many companies, when they're hiring people, actually now provide an EI assessment so that they can get an idea of the areas that you're strong in and that you may need to improve in. Now remember, the potential income and advancement opportunities offered by your career in the medical sales industry, while perhaps being a strong motivator, are not what keep most individuals inspired to continue in this career. Instead, being compassionate, having a strong desire to help others, will help you to be resilient in the face of the inevitable challenges and setbacks you're going to face in your role as a medical sales rep. So to sum up, for the purposes of this video, confidence, conviction, and compassion, these are three things you must have to succeed at being a medical sales rep. Please remember to subscribe to the channel, hit that bell so you are notified whenever I have a new video ready for you, and remember to hit that thumbs up button. It really helps out the channel. I appreciate you very much for watching this, and I wish you all the success you can handle. Have a great day.